A while back, I had a debate in Mexico with the apostle of scientism, Richard Dawkins. And during that debate, I mentioned a quote from Freeman Dyson. And the quote was, "Every quantum experiment forces the atom to make a choice." So during the debate, I mentioned it, and Dr. Dawkins screamed at me and he said he couldn't have said that. Freeman Dyson could not have said that. And you're misquoting him and he should sue you. So then, of course, I wrote to Freeman Dyson and he was very sweet. He sent us both an email saying that three riddles had occupied him all his life. The first was a universe fine-tuned for mind and consciousness, mind and life, he said. The second was the unpredictable movement of atoms. And then he said, our own consciousness. So, universe fine-tuned for mind and life, the unpredictable movement of atoms, and our own consciousness. Then he said, I don't know the answers to these riddles, but I have a feeling that they're somehow connected to each other. And the email was copied. Michael Shermer was also copied on the email. And Dr. Dawkins didn't respond, but Michael did. He said, your feeling is not good enough. So I've been reflecting on these concepts for a while now. And I'll share with you why I think they are somehow connected. And if we can make that connection, then they offer us an invitation for deep reflection on the nature of existence and our place within it. So let's break down all these three concepts. First, a universe fine-tuned for mind and life. The idea of a fine-tuned universe suggests that the fundamental constants of nature, which includes things like the strength of gravity, the speed of light, or the charge of an electron, are precisely calibrated to allow for the emergence of life and ultimately beings like us that have a mind, etc. If these constants were even slightly different, stars might not form, chemistry might not exist, and life as we know it would be impossible. The fine-tuning raises profound questions. Is it mere coincidence? Is it a product of a multiverse where countless universes exist with varying parameters? Or does it point to some deeper purpose or design? Regardless of one's stance, the fact that the universe supports not just life but also minds capable of contemplating its structure suggests a possible alignment between the cosmos and consciousness. Two, the unpredictable movement of atoms. At the microscopic level, quantum mechanics reveals that particles like atoms and electrons behave unpredictably. Their movements are governed by probabilities rather than deterministic laws. This unpredictability is not chaos, but rather a kind of structured unpredictability. I would say that structured unpredictability is also a creativity that underpins everything in the universe. What is fascinating is how the quantum uncertainty scales up to influence larger systems. For example, quantum processes are essential to the phenomena like photosynthesis in plants, which is the basis of all life, and even neural activity in our brains. This unpredictability might be a key ingredient in enabling creativity, free will, and the emergence of complex systems like life itself. Then, number three, our own consciousness. The subjective experience of being aware remains one of the greatest mysteries in science and philosophy. How does the brain, a collection of atoms and molecules, Obeying physical laws gives rise to thoughts, emotions, self-awareness, and imagination. So, of course, a lot of current theories suggest that consciousness emerges from complex interactions within neural networks. So, of course, as you know, I don't subscribe to that. I feel that consciousness is a more fundamental and is more fundamental, a property woven into the fabric of reality itself as the ground of being, and that the brain itself is a concept for a mode of knowing and perception in that consciousness. In any case, when we consider these three ideas together, fine-tuning, atomic unpredictability, and consciousness, a fascinating picture starts to emerge. If the universe is fine-tuned for life and mind, could it be that its ultimate purpose is to give rise to sentient beings capable of understanding it, such as Homo sapiens? The unpredictable movement of atoms might provide the flexibility needed for creativity and novelty in evolution, leading to the increasing complex forms like the human mind. And then, of course, there are theories in quantum mechanics that suggest that quantum processes may play a role in what is called the collapse of the wave function. So there might be a feedback loop. Quantum uncertainty allows for free will and spontaneity in thought, and our consciousness also allows us to study and reflect on the fine-tuning of the universe. In doing so, we become participants in a cosmic feedback loop. We are the products of the universe who turn back to observe it. This raises philosophical questions about whether consciousness is merely a mechanistic product or emergent property, as some mainstream scientists suggest, or is there purposeful unpredictability, which is creativity itself. So these concepts, fine-tuning, atomic unpredictability, and consciousness, seem deeply intertwined in ways we are only beginning to understand. They suggest that reality operates on multiple levels, that reality operates from precise mathematical constants governing cosmic order to the probabilistic dance of particles at the smallest scales to the profound mystery of human awareness. So I think, in my opinion, this reflects divine intention, natural law, or something beyond our comprehension. As Premin Dyson himself said, God is what the mind becomes when it passes the threshold of our comprehension. Let me know what you think.